Welcome to A Pastor's Perspective. I'm Ken Gray, and I serve as a pastor here at Calvary Life Family Worship Center. And today our devotion will be in Acts chapter 20. Paul has just gone through some very difficult times, and as he proceeds, we read in verse 1 of chapter 20, "After the uproar had ceased, Paul sent for the disciples. And when he had exhorted them and taken his leave of them, he left to go to Macedonia. When he had gone through those districts and had given them much exhortation, he came to Greece. And there he spent 3 months, and when a plot was formed against him by the Jews, he was about to set sail for Syria, he decided to return through Macedonia." We see this frequently in Paul's life, that he's facing not only opposition, but even the challenge of his life being taken from him. And yet, Paul consistently and persistently stays on track, trying to encourage and exhort other people. And wherever he goes, he has this posture of encouraging and exhorting the church of Jesus Christ. And it seems that no matter what happens to him or what threats come against him, he doesn't seem to flinch with regards to his mission. And my question is this morning is, how is it possible that Paul could stay on track with the continuous adversities that he's facing? Well, I believe we have a key, and it's found in verse 4, a verse that I often would think might not need to be included, but today I see is very significant. "And he was accompanied by Sopater of Berea, the son of Pyrrhus, and by Aristarchus and Secundus of the Thessalonians, and Gaius of Derbe, and Timothy and Tychicus and Trophimus of Asia. These had gone on before him and were waiting for us at Troas." As we look at these verses here, it becomes really apparent that Paul had quite a team around him. He had a number of significant relationships, people and men that he had poured into on a regular basis. And these people became very attached to Paul. Paul, when writing his various letters, will conclude them oftentimes making a list of significant names of people that he had developed relationships. Paul was one who valued highly loving, caring relationships, so much so that at one point when a prophecy came about threats and dangers that he was to face, some people begged him not to go to those various places, but Paul persisted in doing what God wanted. So as we look at these verses, we see that these men were very likely not only disciples of Paul, but were men who stood beside him, encouraging him and strengthening him, even warning him of upcoming adversities so that he could adjust his course and his travels. We read here in verse 6, "We sailed from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread and came to them at Troas within 5 days, and there we stayed 7 days." So their travel took 5 days, but they stayed in the presence of these men and ministered to them for 7 more days. I believe it's important for us to understand in life, we're all going to face adversities. We're all going to face people who oppose us as we persist in trying to do what God calls us to do. But there's nothing that will really sustain us like having strong, loving relationships around us. One of the reasons that I find it so exciting to be here as a part of Calvary Life Family Worship Center is the incredible relationships that God has blessed us with. We had relationships when we came, and then God added even stronger relationships to those, and we continue to find ourselves encouraged and strengthened in our walk and in our life with Christ. You need a church family. You need relationships. You need people surrounding you that love and care for you, and you also need to pour into them as well and encourage them. Let me pray with you today. Father, if there be any watching today that do not value relationships, I pray that you would put it in their heart today to see the incredible benefit of having loving, close relationships, where when we face adversity, We have someone who stands with us, some man, some woman, some friend. Lord, we pray that you would teach us the importance and the value of valuing not only the ministry that you've given us, but valuing the relationships that you put us into in your family. We thank you for this great family, and we pray that you would be glorified in and through it. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, God bless you, and thank you for listening to A Pastor's Perspective. We'll be joining you in a couple of days with another perspective as we continue on in our study in the book of Acts. And on this Wednesday night at 7, we will continue our study in the book of Genesis as well, here at Calvary Life Family Worship Center in Cheshire. And we would love to have you come and join us in person, or join us when we are live on Facebook. And we pray that you will be encouraged and strengthened as you continue to study God's Word. God bless you, and have a great day.